The Prime Minister and opposition leader have taken their fight over national security to the top end. Scott Morrison and Anthony Albanese are tonight in Darwin on the eve of a historic military anniversary.
On a boat built to keep watch in troubled waters, a Prime Minister with a federal election firmly in sight.
Well, thank you all very much for your service.
Scott Morrison in the top end, keeping focus on national security with a defence announcement.
$282 million of further investment here in the Northern Territory.
In a bid to convince voters that in more dangerous times, he should be the one navigating the country's path.
People have to make a choice between the most left-wing leader of the Labor Party to be Prime Minister or a Prime Minister who has protected our borders.
After a slanging match in Canberra over an increasingly aggressive China, both leaders took their fight to the Northern Territory.
What Scott Morrison keeps trying to do as a desperate political measure is divide the country.
The Prime Minister has been accusing Anthony Albanese of being soft on Beijing. And as Scott Morrison visited a Navy base near the port of Darwin, the opposition leader fired back, pointing to the 99-year lease on the port to a Chinese company.
That shouldn't have happened in the first place, and we opposed it at the time.
The Prime Minister says it's under a defence review.
If there are recommendations, I will not hesitate.
After a bad start to the year, the Prime Minister clearly believes the national security fight is helping him regain ground. Experts argue looking tough on this issue won't help win an election, but appearing to be soft could be a problem.
But it can probably lose a party in election.
That's why on the pre-election trail, Scott Morrison is on the tools, wanting to be seen as a man of steel.
Yeah, you got him, mate.
But Anthony Albanese could test his mettle.
Fiona Willen joins us from Darwin tonight. And, Fee, tomorrow will look very different for the leaders.
Georgie, they'll both still be here tomorrow, but the day will strike a very different tone. And that's because Scott Morrison and Anthony Albanese are here to mark the 80th anniversary of the bombing of Darwin. So they'll put their differences aside for the day to pay their respects at two commemorative services. After that, the campaigning will ramp up again, with Scott Morrison heading to Melbourne and Anthony Albanese sticking around here a little longer. Georgie?
Fiona Willen, thank you.